is up, guys? It is Canna King. Gonna play a little bit of the forest today. This is the first video of, hell, I don't know, maybe 6 or 7 videos. I'm gonna be showing all the weapon locations, also the rebreather, the chainsaw, stuff like that. So stick with me. Let's see here. We'll start a new game. I'm gonna do it in creative mode just for the sake of getting the locations on. Alright, let me invite T. Pearson into the game. Let's see where you at, buddy. Invite to game. Alrighty, there you are. Now I'm going to try to run through this as quickly as I can to spare you the sake of your time. Later on, I'm going to be releasing a video showing how to get the key card and eventually beat the game. So if you don't know how to beat the game, stick around and... this series, I'm going to call it, I guess, the forest series. Weapon locations, item locations, shit like that. I'm not sure why. Alright, here we go. Where have we spawned? What you want to do is run out and look for the closest, I guess, structure. Or, alright, there's Geese Lake. Since we're on this side of the map, I guess we will run to where the rebreather is, and the rusty axe. So basically, to get to the rebreather, you need to know where the yacht's at. I know where I am right now because I have several hours of gameplay. Shipping containers are over that way. So the yacht should be right around this bend. T. Pearson's not far behind. Right. Here's the scientist camp or whatever. Gives you flares and shit like that. A lot of resources to collect here. I'm just collecting flares for the sake of light later on. Okay, you can also collect an old pot. Lots of items and shit you can get there. But we're focused on the main things. Right now we are going after the rebreather, and we'll also be picking up the rusty axe, I believe, on the way. Alright, we should be extremely close. Yes, we are. Alright, now, in order to find this cave, it's kind of hard. So, what you're going to do is you're going to see... this tent right here also has an old pot. You're gonna take this tent and walk straight back over here to this clearing. About, I don't know, right in through here somewhere, and start heading up. You'll see like a rock type cave, see? Right here. Got some cannibals, but we're just gonna go inside the cave here. Some light. There we go. I don't have any cloth or anything, but I'll use a couple of flares. Now, warning, the rebreather cave does have quite a few cannibals in it, so we're gonna have to be careful as we make our way. Just kind of stick to the left and go up this way. Now, might be some cannibals in this area, but you can collect a decent amount of cloth. These boxes right here will give you a lot of cloth. need some sticks. Don't have any. Some cloth. Now you're gonna come down here, break this open. Continue. Down here there should be candles. Two or three of them. Wasn't there a flashlight down here or something? Yeah, there's a flashlight right here. So in this episode, you got lucky and also learned where the flashlight is. Okay. That was the flashlight location. Well, one of them anyway. There's another one in cave two. Now we're gonna go down here. I know how that is. There's some things you can look at there, but just continue right back this way and you will find the rebreather. Here we are, guys. Pick yourself a rebreather, grab you an oxygen tank, and now in order to equip it, you find it right here behind your backpack and you click with your left clicker and it should automatically equip. Now here we go. Jump down in this water. Continue through here. Now there's a lot of swimming involved, but not this cave, but the next one will have the rusty axe. Alright. There's gonna probably be some baby spawnlings up here. So kinda be careful as you go, because you can die pretty quickly from these bastards. Normally they'll be riding through here somewhere. There's a couple oxygen tanks, some flares. There's also some meds. Now we're gonna jump down here into the water again. We're gonna swim through here. And you'll come to this cave opening. Once here, you're gonna come to this door. Place a stick on the door. It'll open it a little bit. You're gonna have to place more items on the thing. So we'll place another stick. Okay. T Pearson, you got another stick you can add? Yeah, add one. Through the door. Now, for the sake of hanging a stick, I'm gonna take my stick back. Now, you will come to a large room. In this room, there'll be some stuff over there to look at, but this is what you're concerned about. Got some old gun ammo here, got some sodas, you got a Bible. Got a couple of flares. Got some. This right here is the chainsaw gasoline. We'll get to the chainsaw in a later episode. The rusty axe is right here. Pick that up. I'm not going to look at all that stuff because it'll put my torch out. Okay, that's basically everything in this room. There's a couple other things to look at, but not any items. So what we're going to do is jump down in the water here again. And go all the way down. Just keep going down. Alright, now you'll see this archway here. This will bring you to a small opening, and then you'll have to swim to Geese Lake, I believe. It's actually going to take us across the map again. So, once we get out, I believe I'm going to end this video and do another video for the modern axe, the katana, and other various items. Okay, we come to a rope. We're gonna just climb up the rope. swim up. Awesome, it's daytime. Geese light. Yeah, they need to work on that. The birds are kind of glitched a little bit. Alright guys, thanks for watching today. And if you enjoyed the video and want to see more, I'm going to be releasing some more videos on the Katana, the Modern Axe, the ID card, how to beat the game, all that good stuff about the forest. Also, there's going to be somewhat of a guide explaining base locations and stuff like that. For any of those interested, if you're new to the game, I encourage you to keep playing the game. It is fucking awesome. This is Canna King, and I believe I'm out.